Yesterday we looked at how to realize a current controlled current source using a MOS transistor. What we tried to do, what we tried to realize was a current controlled current source with a gain of 1. In this way it is similar to the voltage controlled voltage source, which we also realized with a gain of 1. Okay. And we saw that first of all with a gain of 1, it means that the current from the input source has to flow through the MOS transistor. That's basically what it means. Okay. So this problem is basically the same thing as biasing a transistor at a given current. The only thing extra that's required here is that when you bias a transistor at a given current, you want to make a certain current flow in the transistor, and that's about it. Here you have to make the drain current of the transistor, the incremental drain current of the transistor, equal to the input current, and also that current must be available to be driven into a load. Okay. So that's why every one of the techniques we use for biasing a transistor may not be suitable for this. The most suitable, it turns out, looks like source feedback biasing. Okay. We have I naught here because of feedback to the source terminal. We know that the current in the MOS transistor will be I naught. Similarly, in the incremental signal picture, the gate is connected to ground and the input source is connected to the source. This of course makes sure that this current goes into the MOS transistor. At least when RS is not there, you can easily see that. And also it is available at the drain to be driven into a load impedance. Okay. So this is the current controlled current source using a MOS transistor. And you can see that the input is between source and gate. It is between source and ground, and the gate terminal is connected to ground in the incremental picture, and the output is between drain and ground or drain and gate. So this is also known as a common gate amplifier. Okay. So we have seen the common source amplifier and the common drain amplifier. In fact, this was the only thing left. So this is the common gate amplifier. Common source amplifier is the basic MOS transistor without feedback. Common drain amplifier is the voltage controlled voltage source with a gain of 1, and common gate amplifier is the current controlled current source with a gain 1. Okay. And we analyzed the incremental picture. We saw that the input resistance is 1 by GM and the output resistance is GM RDS RS plus RS plus RDS. Okay. And the gain is this, many ways to write it. You can write it as GM RS by 1 plus GM RS and so on. Okay. By the way, we have derived these things with different assumptions. For the gain, we assume that RDS is infinity. For RI, also we assume that RDS is infinity. Okay. And this is the output resistance is derived with finite value of RDS and RS. Okay. Any questions about the incremental picture? So this is again quite simple once you know how to analyze the circuit and derive these things. Now we have to combine this with some suitable bias circuit. What bias circuit could I use? Again, source feedback seems the most convenient because the source is not connected to ground. Okay. So I start with the source feedback structure. Which is this, and I have to connect the input source. I could AC couple that. And how do I take the output? I have a load and I have to drive the output current into the load. So what should I do? What is that? Is this fine? We have to have some element here, either a resistor or an inductor, or we could also have a resistor which we try to make very large, but of course then you need a larger supply. See, the output side of this is exactly the same as the voltage controlled current source. Okay, so whatever we discussed for the output side of the voltage controlled current source also applies here. If you use a large inductor, then all of the incremental current will flow into the load. If you use a resistor, a part of it will flow into the resistor, and you can try to maximize the portion that flows into the load by making the resistor very large. But we do know that that comes with a trade-off. If you have a very large resistor, then your supply voltage will be very large as well. Okay. If it is an ideal current source, it does not matter. Again, it is assumed that, see, if this is an ideal current source, it can tolerate any voltage across it and you can simply connect it anywhere you want. But again, this is a representation of some other circuit, okay. So it is assumed that it will have its voltage limits, which you want to keep independent of what voltage you have at the source terminal here, okay. So if possible, you can connect it directly. We will see that example in some time. But if that is not possible, this capacitor is there, okay. This, by the way, applies to every circuit that I show. In general, I mean, in the beginning I am showing every circuit with AC coupling. That is because I bias each circuit independently, okay. But if you design many circuits together, in many cases it is possible to just get rid of the AC coupling. You just have to make sure that the output bias of one stage, the output operating point, is what is required for biasing the following stage. If you do that, then you do not need AC coupling, okay. AC coupling was required because we have want to have some bias values and that may not be there along with the signal automatically, okay. So we bias the gate like this. In the incremental picture, the gate is connected to ground. So what should I do? What is it connected to in the actual circuit? What is connected to the gate? What is it? R1 parallel R2 connected to ground. So okay. Now, if you restrict yourself to this model, then it looks like the gate voltage is still 0, right, because no current flows into the gate and it is still 0. But remember, this is not enough actually, because there is a capacitance between gate and source, this we discussed earlier, okay. So if you do have this capacitance, then this input current, a part of it can go into the capacitance at higher frequencies and cause some voltage swing at the gate. Whereas you do want the gate to be shorted to ground. So what you do is, although it is not apparent from this picture, you do have to connect a capacitor here to ground, and this has to be much more than the reactance of the capacitor has to be much smaller than whatever is across it, and in this case the constraint is usually from the gate source capacitance, okay. Because if you didn't have the gate source capacitance, the voltage there would be zero anyhow. You won't even have to worry about it. Okay? So it's because the gate source capacitance is there that the voltage at the gate could be non-zero. You can analyze that. I mean, you could analyze the circuit using this CGS and see what happens. Okay? In that case, not all of II will go to the output and the input impedance will be some weird stuff that you can see. Okay? No, there is no the feedback here. This is not that compensation refers to getting the loop gain to be in the right structure for stability. This there is no risk of instability. Okay, so this is not that stuff at all. This is simply to keep the gate quiet and to have zero signal swing at the gate. Any questions? So in the actual circuit, you do have to ground the gate with a capacitor. Then all of the incremental current will simply flow through the transistor, and if you do use an inductor, it will flow into the load. Okay? Yeah, so that is what gives you the condition, that is what gives you this voltage being nearly zero. Okay? If you imagine, I mean, forget the rest of the circuit, just imagine the capacitors. Okay. If I have Vx here, what will be the voltage there? This is a phasor Vx, what will be that voltage? Yeah, so CGS by CGS plus C3 times Vx, that will be the voltage there. And you want it to be negligible, so C3 has to be much more than CGS. Okay. Meaning? Yeah. So I didn't specify the polarity of II. Is that what you're referring to? Yeah. II could be positive. That's fine. I mean, II could be negative also. That means that. II is defined in this direction, but the value of II if negative, it is actually pushing current that way. Okay, that means that the incremental drain current is negative. So, the current is current in the MOS transistor is falling from its quiescent value. Okay, that is possible. Any questions about this? This is quite simple. Also, partly also because I mean elements of the circuit we have been analyzed before. Okay, the input resistance of this is basically the same as the output resistance of the source follower, right? The input resistance here is 1 by GM. Why? I mean, we are looking at the resistance between this terminal and ground, and that's exactly what you look at when you look at the output of the source follower. Okay? The output part of it between here and ground, it's exactly the same as in the voltage controlled current source. Okay? So all these things are related. So you should also understand the connections between these circuits. Okay, they're all quite similar. Any questions about the common gate amplifier or the current controlled current source? What is that? C3. Yeah. So the gate should be connected to ground, right? In the small signal picture, at least this is the picture that we derived. Okay. By the way, what happens if the gate is not connected to ground? You don't know what the voltage there is, right? In fact, because of the capacitor, it turns out that you will not get an input resistance of 1 by GM and so on. So, in the incremental picture, the gate has to be connected to ground. Okay? Now, if you do the biasing like this, it will be connected to ground through R1 parallel R2. Now, that appears okay because no current is flowing through the gate. But like I said, to understand this properly, the model we have been using without capacitors is not sufficient. Okay? Because you can make the circuit, but you will find that there will be some signal at the gate. That's because there is some CGS over there. Okay? So once you have some signal at the gate, what happens is that not all of the current will be going this way. Okay? Some of it will also be going that way. So the current gain of the circuit could be substantially different from 1. Okay? And you can easily understand that by analyzing the impedance looking in. Okay? So, to make sure that the gate voltage is nearly zero in spite of CGS, you have to connect a large enough capacitor, okay? And that you understand, right? If you can always, I mean, the calculation comes later, but if you have a capacitor that is very large, then the voltage across it will never change. So in the incremental picture, it's like a short circuit, okay? So that's getting shorted to ground. Now, how do you calculate it? You can evaluate the, with II, you can evaluate the actual voltage here and make sure that it is much smaller than VGS, okay? There is some VGS and there is some VG, okay? So VG should be nearly zero compared to VS, basically that's the idea. If you do that, you will find that C3 has to be much more than CGS, okay? Any other questions? How can we? So we are a lot more used to voltages than currents. So sometimes when you have a current input or output, it is common to convert it as voltage input or voltage output, okay? So what I mean is this. Let me take the let me consider the common gate amplifier like this. Now, you can always represent the same thing as this, where Vi will be minus II times Rs, right? So you can think of it as between this point and that point, voltage transfer function, okay? So this is V0, and what will be approximately V0 by Vi? What will be V0 by Vi in this case? What is the current that is flowing here through the input source, driven from the input source? What is the resistance looking in here? 1 by GM. Okay, so what is the current flowing this way? What is that? Vi? So the current here is Vi by Rs plus 1 by Gm. The same current flows out, okay? So what is V0? RL by Rs plus 1 by Gm, okay? So V0 by Vi is RL by Rs plus 1 by Gm, okay? So, and you can approximate it with RL by Rs if Gm Rs is much more than 1, which is anyway the condition for making a good common gate amplifier, okay? Then, now, I mean, sometimes you can also, it's not often used like that, but you can also think of it as a voltage amplifier with Rs equals 0. That is, if I connect the voltage source right here, what will be the output voltage? I mean, all you have to do is to substitute Rs equals 0, right? What will it be? Yeah, so it will be V0 by Vi will be plus Gm RL, okay? So you could use it with a voltage input. It's not often done like that because when you have a voltage source as input, you would also like to connect it to something that has a high input impedance, okay? So that the voltage source is not loaded. But in this case it is loaded, but if you do think about it like that, from the source to drain it has plus GMRL, and it's very much like the common source amplifier except for an inversion in sine. Okay, so generally whenever you have a current input or output, you can always turn it around and say that you have a voltage input. Of course the opposite can also be done. Whenever you have a voltage input, you can also apply a current input. That's less common. I mean, in principle there is no difference between the two. Okay, any amplifier with a voltage input, like for instance, let's say you have a voltage controlled voltage source. Okay, so I can always drive this with a current source, right? II, RS, and RL, and I think of current as the output. So what will be I naught? K times II times RS divided by RL. Okay. Now I naught by II will be K times RS by RL. Okay. So you can always think of whatever quantity you want as the input and output. But the point is, this is still not a current controlled current source. Why? Even if I present it like this, I won't call this a current controlled current source. Why is that? It depends on RS and RL. Okay, the whichever transfer ratio doesn't depend on the source and load resistor, the controlled source corresponds to that one. Okay, so in this case it depends on RS and RL. So it is really not a current controlled current source. Okay, but you can always treat anything you want as either input or output. So in that way, if you do it for a common gate amplifier, you will have a positive gain, which is useful in some cases. And you can also try it with RS equals 0, not often used like that, but if you do use it, the gain from here to there will be plus GMRL, which is the same magnitude but opposite sign as the common source amplifier. Okay. Any questions? That completes three of the four control sources. We had voltage controlled voltage source, current control voltage controlled current source, and current controlled current source. What is left? Current controlled voltage source. Okay. Now this must follow. V naught is II times some let me call it RM. Okay, just like GM, which is the transconductance, we have RM, which is the trans resistance. It's the ratio of voltage to current, but not between the same two terminals. It's the ratio of output voltage to input current. Okay, and as usual, we want to use a MOS transistor. But we want to use a MOS transistor, but we want to realize this, and also of course using negative feedback. Okay. Is fine. Now, as usual, we have to define some error in the form of a voltage, which will be fed to the gate source so that the output can be driven. Okay, and the output is a voltage, but we can control a voltage using a current source by pushing or pulling current from that node. Okay. So what is an error that you can define? What is V naught? Yeah. So I would like the error also to be in the form of a voltage, because MOS transistor responds to a voltage, right? V naught minus IIRM, or the negative of it. Okay. Because the MOS transistor responds to a gate source voltage, right? Yeah. Isn't it? So you have a basic amplifier with which you may realize negative feedback. Okay. So the input of that amplifier must be the error. So the input of a MOS transistor is a voltage, gate source voltage. So the error has to be in the form of a gate source voltage. Now, what should we do if V naught minus IIRM is more than 0? What should happen to the output voltage? Decreased. So now we have a current source, right? So what should happen to the current? Current must be should you push or pull current in from the output node? Pull current, obviously, right? Because we want to reduce the voltage. So if there is some node at which V naught is available, if V naught minus IIRM is more than 0, current must be drawn out of that node. Okay. Is this fine? Okay. So now tell me what I could connect to what. So I have to have some node at which I get V naught, and I will have some input source II. Okay. So based on this action, the error voltage is V naught minus IIRM. Of course, it could be the flipped version or scaled version of this. That is fine, right? So finally, V naught minus IIRM, when it is equal to 0, we get the relationship that we want. Okay. So if V naught minus IIRM is more than 0, current must be pulled from the output node. So tell me what should be VGS and which one should be the output node. That basically follows this, right? Or you, I mean, many times you can do this by trial and error. I mean, how many output node possibilities are there? You have a MOS transistor with three terminals. Which of them can be the output node? Drain or source. Okay, that's the, those are the only two. So you can think of both and then tell me how to arrange the circuit. Okay, take the output at source then. So take the output at the source, VGS must become equal to what? So if the output is at the source, VGS must be what? Should it be V naught minus IIRM or the negative of that? It should be the negative, right? So that it gets pulled out when V naught is more than IIRM. Okay. So you can see if you can come up with a circuit which can do this. If it works, it works. So then what else? Okay. And then feed it to gate. Actually, what circuit is this? No, you will not. Okay, that's fine. Let's worry about, not worry about the negative gain. What kind of circuit is this? The input is here, the output is there. This is a source follower. You have passed II through RM and followed it by a voltage controlled voltage source. Okay. Is this a current controlled voltage source? What happens if the resistance is if the input current source is imperfect, if it has a resistance in parallel with it? Yeah, current will split and you will not get II times RM. You will get II times RS parallel RM. Okay. So this is exactly what I meant. I mean, it's something like this, right? You pass II through a resistor and then pass it through a voltage controlled voltage source, but that doesn't make a current controlled voltage source. Okay, because then if you have II RS RM, then the voltage here will be II times RS parallel RM. Okay, so we need to do it in a different way. So how should we do that? Where should we take the output? mean, how many other possibilities are there? The drain, okay? And if you take the output at the drain, should the gate source voltage be V0 minus IIRM or IIRM minus V0? Just going by the direction. If V0 minus IIRM is positive, current must be pulled from the output node. So, which way should it be? If VGS is more than 0, what happens to, what happens to the current? Is it pulled from the drain or pushed into the drain? Pulled from the drain. So, what should be VGS? V0 minus IIRM, okay. How do I get V0 minus IIRM? I have V0 somewhere at this node. Obviously, if you have RM in the circuit, so that means that a resistance of value RM is available, okay. So, how do I, and of course, the input current II is also available. How do I get V0 minus II times RM? This is the output node. I have II, I have RM. So, how do I get, yes, you have some ideas? Yeah. Okay. This one. Okay. To ground. But that will only give you IIRM. You want V0 minus IIRM, right? Yeah, difference between these two. Okay. So, this is possible, but you can't make the complete circuit using this because you want this to be equal to VGS. Okay. So, if you connect it up like that, again you will find that you will not get a voltage, current controlled voltage source. Okay. So, but anyway, I mean this design process is always with trial and error. So, you can try many things and see if things work or not. So, another way to do it is this, what will be the voltage here with respect to ground? If this is with respect to ground, what is the voltage there? V0 minus II RM. So, what I do is, I connect RM and if I do that, I also ground the source, okay. It's exactly the same as the previous picture. The voltage between this point and ground is V0 minus IIRM and that I apply as VGS, okay. So, this loop here gives me, I mean this I have grounded here, this loop here gives me V0 minus IIRM at this point with respect to ground and I ground the source and that is all that is there, okay. This is fine? Yeah, so let us see what happens, okay. So, that we have to always analyze, I do the synthesis assuming an ideal current source, but typically if you have an ideal source, you probably do not need any of these control sources, you can do things more easily. Let us see what happens if the current source is imperfect. In fact, the same thing is captured by the input and output resistance characteristics, right? Why, what should be the input resistance of a current controlled voltage source? What is it? Zero. What is the output resistance? It is a voltage source. What is the output resistance? Zero. Okay, both the input and output resistances must be 0. So, we will analyze it and see whether they are, I mean in reality you will get some small values, whatever the small values we will see, okay. Any questions? Yeah, we should, otherwise there is no point in having this, but first let us analyze this step by step, okay. So, this appears like it follows this description, right, because this voltage is V0 minus II times RM and that is equal to the gate source voltage of the transistor. So, if V0 minus IIRM is positive, current will be pulled from the output node reducing the voltage, okay. So, it follows this description, whether it does exactly everything we want from the current controlled voltage source, we will see by analysis, okay. So, first thing is please compute the output voltage V0. What What do you get? Yeah, I think it's reversed in sign, but so this is very easy without the load and source resistances. What's that? No, what is open circuited? Something is connected, right? It's not certainly not a node with one component connected to it. There are two things connected, the control source and the yeah, nothing is connected to V naught, yeah. That's right. So that's why I said that without the load and source resistance, it's extremely easy to calculate. This II flows through the whole thing, right? That's there's only one loop in the circuit. So GM VGS has to be equal to minus II. So what is VGS? What is VGS? Minus II by GM. And what's the voltage across this? What's the voltage across RM? II times RM. So the output voltage between these two equals this plus that, right? So it is II RM minus II by GM, or basically II times RM minus 1 by GM. Okay. What is it that we wanted? What was the relationship that we wanted? II times RM. So when will it be equal to that? GM has to be much more than 1 by RM. Okay. A similar condition to what we had all the time. I mean, GM must be much more than some conductance in the circuit. Now, if you include the load and source resistances, you will get more complicated expressions. But if GM tends to infinity, in every case, you will get the output voltage to be II times RM. Okay. And this is equal to RM if GM tends to infinity. And of course, in practice, you have to design the circuit with GM much more than 1 by RM. Okay. And please also calculate the input and output resistances of the circuit. So the input resistance will be between this and ground, excluding the source, and the output resistance will be between this and ground, okay, with the source deactivated. So please do that. This is quite simple to calculate the input and output resistances. If you apply a test voltage here, obviously GM times V test flows there, and that has to be drawn from the input. So the input resistance is 1 by GM, and similarly for the output resistance. If you apply a test voltage, the complete test voltage appears as VGS. So the current that is drawn is V test by GM, sorry, V test times GM. So the output resistance is also 1 by GM. But of course, this is true only when RS is infinity and RL is infinity, okay. What happens if you have a finite value of RS? Will the output resistance increase or decrease? So the output resistance in this case is 1 by GM. Now I have some RS which is finite. What happens to the output resistance?
Decrease.
Why? You have some extra resistance. Really? Huh? What is the dominant part? What is contributing to the output conductance here? It is feedback, right? In this case, anyway, the current here is 0, okay, but there is, but that does not mean that it is an open circuit. okay, because there is feedback, there is GM times Vtest drawn here, okay. So if you do this, of course you get some extra current here, but that's not going to be the dominant factor, okay. The feedback is reduced. So let's say this is Rm, and just for simplicity, Rs equals Rm. You get only half of Vtest here, so you get only GM by 2 plus some extra resistance because of that part. But remember, first of all, this circuit will be designed with GM much greater than 1 by Rm. So any current flowing here will be much smaller than the current that is flowing there. So actually, if you add a resistance in parallel, the output resistance increases, it doesn't decrease, okay. This is because negative feedback has reduced, okay. Is this fine? So if you don't satisfy this condition, it's possible that it may go some other way, but I mean, this is a, if it's a well designed negative feedback circuit, having Rs only reduces the amount of feedback. So essentially it goes further away from being an ideal voltage source, okay. Ideally voltage source should have 0 resistance. This of course will not have 0, but it has some finite output resistance, which is 1 by GM. If you reduce the amount of feedback, it goes further away from being a voltage source, which means its output resistance is only going to increase, okay. And the same is true for this case. If you have RL, what happens is that Vtest times GM does flow here, but only a part of it will be drawn from the input, okay. So the input resistance also increases if you have this RL in parallel, okay. Is this fine? Have we analyzed all this before or no? For some circuit? Never? So let me see if I can magically find that page. What is the circuit? Gate feedback, drain feedback. The common source amplifier with drain feedback. Now, what is the difference between this and what we are doing now? So this has been replaced by, okay. I mean, it's just a Thevenin Norton equivalent. Of course, the goals were very different. Then what were we trying to do? We were trying to make common source amplifier. No, biasing is fine, but we were trying to make a common source amplifier. We wanted a gain which is minus GMRL times VI, okay. So we had some constraint on RG, okay. But it's exactly the same topology, right. So if I call this the input and call that the output, this circuit is exactly the same as, of course, now this includes biasing. I didn't discuss biasing for our current controlled voltage source, but you can see that this kind of biasing will work well, okay. So the same circuit will behave differently depending on the value of RG that you choose, okay. When you want to make a common source amplifier, you just choose an insanely high value of RG so that it behaves like an open circuit. Now in this present circuit, it looks exactly the same, the topology is the same, it's only the value that is different. The value of RG must be chosen slightly differently, okay. You can't choose some very high value of RG, okay. So this I think we had analyzed all this. So if you take this and apply the correct limits, first of all you substitute VI equals minus II RS, and you make RS equal to infinity or RL equal to infinity, we will get the same expressions as we have got. So please do that just as exercise, and that will also, yeah, this condition is something that we will definitely not have in this case. So this is also to show that the same topology can also be can also have very different behavior depending on the values that you choose, okay. We'll continue from there tomorrow.